Good morning and Happy New Year. Welcome to worship here at First Presbyterian Church of Dallas Center. I'm Pastor Nicole Wegele. It is January 3rd, 2021, and I invite you this morning to a different style of worship. I'm going to be including some elements from Taze. It's a little more contemplative and reflective style of service. The lights I've kind of dimmed in here. And this entire service was done on Zoom. So I'm trying a little different format today as I give you this time to clear your minds, clear your thoughts, and just rest in God's presence as we enter into the first Taze worship song called Holy Spirit, Come to Us. And now we'll stay in a reflective posture and move into our opening reflection by Howard Thurman called Now the Work of Christmas Begins. When the song of the angels is stilled, when the star in the sky is gone, when the king and princes are home, when the shepherds are back with their flocks. The work of Christmas begins, to find the lost, to heal the broken, to feed the hungry, to release the prisoner, to rebuild the nations, to bring peace among the people, to make music in the heart. And now, if you'll join me in our call to worship. O God, we come. We come declaring that we belong to you. O God, we come. We come declaring your victory. O God, we come. We come asking for forgiveness. O God, we come. Celebrating your grace for each of us. Join me as I pray our prayer of illumination. Holy God, we come to you with a posture of reflection and meditation over this past year as we enter into this new season, into this year of Jubilee, into this year of your favor upon our lives. We ask that you cause our hearts to be soft and moldable, that we may hear and understand your word, and we may apply it to our lives, that we may see and know and experience how you are moving among us. We thank you for all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Our scripture today, I'm reading from the Passion Translation, and it's from Isaiah 43, verses 18 and 19. Listen for God's word to you today. Stop dwelling on the past. Don't even remember these former things. I am doing something brand new, something unheard of. Even now, it sprouts and grows and matures. Don't you perceive it? I will make a way in the wilderness and open up flowing streams in the desert. This is the word of God. Thanks be to God. And in our next process in the service, you'll see on your order of worship, it says reflective journaling practice. And there are a set of 5 questions here that I'd like you to take out a journal or something to write with, something maybe you can hang on your bathroom mirror, hang on your closet door, somewhere that you'll see it each day and you can think about it. This is one of the ways I really like to get ready for a new year, a new season, is to kind of go over with God in prayer and reflection over the last year what I need to bring with me and what I need to leave behind so that I'm most ready to enter into this new season with God and allowing God to speak to me during that time. So that's my deepest prayer for each of you as we go through this reflective practice. I'm going to be playing a song in the background, Be Still by The Fray. And as we listen to that, I'd like for you to take the time to write out your answers for these 5 questions. And it culminates in the bottom question. It says, commit to one action towards discipleship this year. So I'm not asking for 5 things you have to add to your schedule, but I am asking you to choose one action from your reflection time as this song plays that you would be willing to commit to between you and God. And nobody's going to be checking on you about it. No, it's all between you and God. But it's a way for you to strengthen your spiritual practice and a way for you to draw closer to God in this season. You know, God makes us a promise that if you draw near me, I will draw near you. And so sometimes it takes us to initiate drawing near. And that's what my desire for this service would be for you, is that you would find one way through your listening prayer, as you're writing in your journal, awaken to the knowledge that God is right there with you, speaking and guiding you as you're writing, as you're thinking, and as you're dreaming over the year 2021, the year of Jubilee. And so I'll begin that song and just ask you to think about the things that you would like to write and also write these down. And we'll move into that time right now. Next, I would like to have another Taze hymn. It's number 3. It's called The Lord is My Song. This song to be our response song for today. So as you're continuing to work through numbers 1 through 5, if you would take this additional time to hear a few of these verses. Taze is very known for taking the same few stanzas and saying them over and over again, so that it's a very easy way to still your mind and kind of focus on one thing. So what is that one action towards discipleship this year, and how will you be able to implement that? I'm going to play that song now and join in if you know it.
Thank you.
I'd like to move us into the prayers of the people. And I know it's your tradition to be able to type in those on the comments or stand up with the microphone. And today I'm just going to pray a prayer that I hope encapsulates us all and gathers us together before the throne of God in prayer. So rejoicing in the gift of Jesus Christ, our Savior, we pray for this world that you love, God, saying, Emmanuel, God with us, hear our prayer. So at this time, I was thinking I'd like to ask each of you that wherever you're watching from, that if each of us could lift up a person's name, a situation, if you would just say their name out loud, that if they are on your heart today with a concern or a joy. So I'm just going to pause for a moment. If you could all just say their name out loud wherever you are. You can have multiple people as well. God Most High, I know you hear every name and you know every situation. We lift our hearts to you, Emmanuel, God with us. Hear our prayer. Amen. Friends, this is the joyful feast of the people of God. They will come from the east and the west, from the north and from the south, and sit at a table just like this in the kingdom of God. According to Luke, when our risen Lord was at the table with his disciples, he took the bread and blessed it and broke it, and he gave it to them. Then their eyes were opened and they recognized him. This is the Lord's table. Our Savior invites all those who would trust in his name to share the feast which he has prepared. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give our thanks and praise. O holy God, it is truly right in our greatest joy to give you thanks and praise, eternal God, our Creator. You have given us life and second birth in your Spirit. Once we were people, we were no people, but now we are your people. You claimed Israel as your chosen nation and raised up the church as a witness to the resurrection, breathing into your life and power. From worlds apart, you gathered us together. When we go astray, you welcome us home. Always your love has been steadfast. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with the choirs of heaven and with all the faithful of every time and every place who forever sing to the glory of your name. Holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are holy, O God of majesty, and blessed is Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. In love with you and in compassion for all, Jesus healed and taught, challenged and comforted, welcomed and saved. He formed a community, promising to be with his disciples wherever two or three were gathered, and sending them on his mission of hope and healing into the world. Jesus trusted his life to you and went freely to his death, so that the world might be set free from suffering and sin. You raised him from death, and raise us also to live a new life with him in the power of the Holy Spirit. You send us out to make disciples, as he commanded. Remembering all your mighty and merciful acts, we take this bread and this wine from the gifts you have given us, and celebrate with joy the redemption won for us in Jesus Christ. Accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, as a living and holy offering of ourselves, God, that our lives may proclaim the one crucified and risen. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Gracious God, pour out your Holy Spirit upon us and upon these, your gifts of bread and wine, that the bread we break and the cup we bless may be the communion of the body and blood of Christ. By your Spirit, unite us with the living Christ and with all who are baptized in his name, that we may be one in ministry in every place. As this bread is Christ's body for us, send us out to be the body of Christ in the world. O God, today you have called us together to be the church. Unite us now at your table and in one lost and common cup, one loaf and common cup. Make us one in Christ Jesus. Let your spirit empower the life we share and ignite our witness in the world. With all who have gone before us, keep us faithful to the gospel, teachings, and fellowship, to the breaking of bread and the prayers. Give us strength to serve you until the promised day of the resurrection, when with the redeemed of all the ages, we will feast with you at your table in glory. Through Christ, all glory and honor are yours, Almighty God, with the Holy Spirit and the Holy Church, now and forever. Amen. As Christ our Savior taught us, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. The Lord Jesus, on the night of his arrest, he took the bread, and after blessing it, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And in the same way, he took the cup. Saying, "This cup is the new covenant sealed in my blood, shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this in remembrance of me." Every time you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the saving death of the risen Lord until he indeed comes again. These are the gifts of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. So wherever you are invited to this table that Jesus has given for us. So if you'll take the bread, whatever communion bread you have to use, if you'll take it. This is the body of Christ broken for you. And in the same way, take the cup and your juice or whatever you have. This is the cup of salvation shed for you. Join me as I pray. Gracious God, may we who have received this sacrament live in the unity of your Holy Spirit, that we may show forth your gifts to all the world. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. I have another song to share with you. It's called Reckless Love by Corey Asbury. And then after that, we'll move to the Blessing in Charge.
Singing over me, you have been so, so good to me. Before I took a breath, you breathed your life in me, God. You have been so, so kind to me. Down, fights till I'm found, leaves the 99. I couldn't earn it, I don't deserve it. Still, you give yourself away. The overwhelming, never ending, reckless love. I couldn't earn it.
So your blessing and charge for today. The loving kindness of the Lord our God, the grace of Jesus Christ our Savior, and the renewing power of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Hallelujah. Now go and serve the Lord with gladness and joy. Amen. Thanks for joining today.